This is one of the things I love about Samuel Yellin's work is these scrolls were done with excellence, but they were not done with perfection. And I feel like in a lot of modern blacksmithing, we worship perfection instead of excellence. Because you cannot tell me that this gate is not a work of excellence. And there's a difference between sloppy work and then allowing the work to breathe like this and have those beautiful imperfections. He was a master at that.
In the beautiful city of Pittsburgh this weekend, going to check out some ironwork and be around for my daughter's volleyball tournament. So join me for a cool tour of some historic ironwork in Pittsburgh.
Here's some cool public sculpture, Liberty Avenue musicians, but check out this iron screen behind it. Very cool. Not sure who did this, but it's really awesome. Huge fish up there. Beautiful copper repousse work. Find out and post the name later. But I'll copy her up as A. Getting ready to go across the street to this building, which is the Allegheny County Courthouse, Allegheny, Pennsylvania. And we're gonna check out some Samuel Yellin gates.
Okay, so check it out, everyone. These beautiful gates by master blacksmith Samuel Yellin. I'll flip this camera around and we're gonna check out some of the details.
So Yellin was always a master of layering and building up. You see that here with the twisted bars and the flat, just building out that bulkhead of these gates. Lovely forged scroll work. It's kind of like a star detail in the center. The collars, all these put on hot, wrapped on their hot. Check out how beautiful the handle, nice little forged finial. Look at this, all hot chiseled in there. These lovely half round pieces. Again, just layering up and building up for this lockbox. It's a shame that this chain is on here. Really detracts from the appearance, but you can see how lovely just that lockbox is. So gorgeous. And these hot repousse flowers. Split one in the center. Then look how beautiful this nice heavy, this is about 1¼ inches square, transitioning to the stonework.
If you don't know anything about Samuel Yellin, he was a master blacksmith. He had over 200 some blacksmiths working in his shop at one point. Just an incredible shop, did incredible work all around the country. Much of it in kind of a Gothic style, but one of the most famous blacksmiths, certainly in American history, and probably one of the biggest decorative ironwork shops in our country. Not the biggest blacksmith shop or the biggest ironworking shop, but definitely one of the biggest decorative ironworking shops in the country. Beautiful work. I always love to check it out, so being out here in Pittsburgh for my daughter's volleyball tournament, I thought I would sneak around the city, find a few pieces I never get the chance to see otherwise.
These are more active entrants and don't have a chain around them. What I always love to see is how dirty and dusty this work is. And then look, this is all polished because everyone has their hands on it coming in and out every day. But just a testimony to the blacksmith craft that 100 years later, these are still standing tall and proud, functioning, doing their job. Okay, this is the back of the courthouse. I'm not sure if this is Yellin or not. It looks a little bit too static. Might have been added later. But these are definitely Yellin. Check them out. It's nice flat forged finial. These half scrolls, beautiful hot twist. Look at the size of this plate. It's half inch thick. It's gotta be 8 inches by 16 inches. These bars are like inch and an eighth square. But look at this. This bar here is easily 2.5 inches square. And check out that hinge connection. Just a beautiful hot wrap. This bar transitions here from square to round inside of there. It functions as a hinge. Lovely work by the master. The matching part on the other side. And then through this portico, there's other gates on the other side. Again, check out something on this gate, 2.5 inch square, huge bolt in pintle there, but check out this pintle on the ground. See that in comparison to my hand? This is like 5 inch round probably, and bolted in there, probably went down into the masonry as well. And check out these reverse finials on the bottom of the gate. Just no detail left out. Transitioning here from this plane to this plane, the bars bolt up, all done before welding. Beautiful work. So I haven't said much about these railings, but check them out as well. All forged out of inch square. Beautiful scroll work. Not sure if they're Yellin. And then look how beautiful these forged hinges. You can see the hammer marks in the light when it's right. See also the lap weld where they forge welded it in. Beautiful. So far I've counted 5 sets of gates, and then I look across the street, see that. Check out how beautiful that is. Oh my gosh, just a lovely design. And sometimes it's hard to appreciate the size of things, but now this looks like it's been repaired, replaced at one point, reset higher. Not sure what's going on out here. This is not original. Maybe these were reset at a later date because they realized they were historic and they shouldn't move them. Outside of the Allegheny County Courthouse, we have this. Again, these are the gates on the other side. I was just all the way through there showing you those other gates, but they're the sister pair to those. How gorgeous. Lovely forged scrolls. some finials in the middle of the gate, and it goes up. These beautiful forged diamond finials.
I almost did a project one time where we forged a bunch of these for a huge property in Colorado.
It fell through, and I'm proudly thankful it did.
So, funny thing, checking out historic ironworks and historic buildings. This is a courthouse, so the guard just came out and talked to me and was like, hey, what you up to? I was like, hey, I'm just a blacksmith and metal nerd. I love architecture. Checking out some beautiful historic ironworks, but that's not the first time it's happened to me. Last time was actually at the Federal Reserve Bank in New York City. They always wonder when people are walking around buildings taking pictures, but some of us truly are just appreciating the beauty and the details and the work, in this case, of master blacksmith Samuel Yellin. So hope to make it over a little bit later this evening to the Cathedral of Learning. That, I heard, has some fantastic Yellin work as well. But if I get to see nothing else, what I've seen here at this courthouse and just taking a quick stroll through town has been worth it.
Okay, check out this skyscraper. It's like 65 floors. It was built in 1967, but it's entirely clad in steel. And hey, we are in Steel City. This is Pittsburgh. But it's the tallest building in Pittsburgh and the fifth tallest in Pennsylvania. Just a massive building. Holy cow. Entirely clad in steel. You just don't see that many skyscrapers clad in steel. So cool.
Alrighty, so it's 8 o'clock at night. I'm in Pittsburgh still, at the University of Pittsburgh, and getting ready to go into a beautiful building called the Cathedral of Learning, where there's supposed to be a bunch of great Samuel Yellin work. Well, check it out. There's the cathedral behind me. Pretty awesome building.
These are bifold gates. Look how awesome these hinges are. Really amazing. These collar wraps, little different chisel detail on each of them. Cross hatch, kind of a star pattern. So gorgeous. Handle, so beautifully forged. This ornate chisel work all across here, just gorgeous. Even this cane bolt is just beautiful, decorative knob on it. And look at how they attach the scrolls at the bottom of the gate. These wraps that step out. These are massive. These are like, I guess, 12 foot tall. Then look at all the animal heads peeking out on this side of the gate. Just absolutely amazing. Fantastic work. I'm talking quietly because this is basically a kind of a study hall for the university. But look at the detail in the chisel work. Just extraordinary on that lockbox. All of this. So cool. And then these, the main gate members, are just a massive forged octagon. Wow.
through detail, split hot. Beautiful railings. They're all around this room. Every side. Amazing twist. This whole panel. Just fantastic. This beautiful detail here wraps through hot. This caper is about 3 inches wide. This amazing rail. Check out this little lap detail on the top. And then the chisel work. And this bar is different, twisted. This bar is different from that. Just phenomenal. So you can put this together on site. This is a nut. And then you center punch here to lock it together on site. detail riveted on here. And then this forge back on itself hot. And this huge banding collar. Just phenomenal. There's a bunch of railings up there. I want to see if I can figure out how to get up there. So, this is inside of one of these rooms. Looks like a lecture hall. Check out those lights. Just amazing. This is on the back side of this door, exiting out. The rosettes holding, it's like a red leather onto the door. These rails are all over the third floor of the cathedral. These are about 1¼ inches square. And they punch through them to rivet on this element, which holds this element. All hot work done. But look how three-dimensional with these large scrolls. To get. Large rivets. That's where I was filming earlier, down there. Another little beautiful detail. These collars were set on the back side, and then on the front side, they pinched them in here and here to lock them in. These were all set hot. Okay, so I apologize for all the whispering in there, but the main areas where all that great Yellin work is essentially the 24/7 study hall of Pitt University. Forged bronze and aluminum work by Pittsburgh metal worker Hyman Blum. Torchere stand in bronze. Beautiful bronze railing. All riveted together. Look how nicely that's done. And then this is another torchere stand in aluminum. All forged. Beautiful work. Okay, so that wraps up this tour of metalwork in Pittsburgh at the John Heinz Museum. That was work by Hyman Blum
And I'm happy to include that in this tour because as much as I love Samuel Yellin and all of his work, many companies like Blum Crafting Company, Hyman Blum's company, are overlooked historically. And so great way to wrap this one up. Thanks again for joining us and subscribing. We appreciate it. Catch you on the next one.